Father, we pray for the first responders. Father, we pray for the police officers, the sheriff's department, all the people that keep us safe, Lord. Heavenly Father, we just pray that you be with us today and everything we say and do will be pleasing to you. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, I don't know how many times this has happened in the history of board meetings in the modern day, but this is my first meeting with no power.
2020.
Yeah, if it happened in 2020, it's happened in 2020. So here we are. But gentlemen, if y'all had an opportunity to review the minutes of our September 30th special call meeting, we just need a motion and a second to approve those minutes.
Motion, man.
Got a motion by Nate, a second by Scott. Any question or discussion? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries. Next is a review and approve the first reading of fiscal year 2021 budget amendment number 3, ordinance number 220.219. This is amending some money in that's coming. I forget exactly the dollar amount, a little over $4,000 for a sheriff's office grant.
Hey.
And like that, we've got power. And then the other was money coming in, $17,445, to help offset the cost of the election. You know, because obviously we're having early voting and there'll be a lot of poll worker pay that's not typically goes with the election. So this is amending money in. I need a motion and a second and a roll call vote. We would need a motion and a second to authorize that resolution and authorize the judge to sign it. It would be getting up to an 80% of the actual money spent on these projects, but not to exceed $40,100. And I don't know, Bobby, do you know what dollar amount you think we're looking at on these projects total?
That's the 80% of what we estimate the project.
Okay, so.
That is part of that project includes our in-kind labor, so.
So we won't really have dollars, that another dollar amount, but we would get up to $40,100.
I say this on Hazel Flat Road and McHenry Chapel. We're at, on these roads.
The McHenry Chapel, it's the loop.
Okay.
Which is that gully right below that where the Ellis Boy lives.
Okay.
And then the other one, Hickory Flat, is there towards on the 100 and towards 100.
Oh, okay.
For us.
The gully
drive
portions.
Okay.
All right.
So
good. Motion by Marty, second by Nate. Any other question or discussion? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed?
Well, Peter, we're talking about drainage. I'm probably still there to make an American mistake. So that would be somebody I feel like going further than you.
Right below Tractor Supply?
Yeah. And so if you all call me, just keep, maybe if we keep telling them enough times they will fix it, but that water, they did not fix the drainage right out of the Tractor Supply parking lot.
And it was shingles
the
road.
I've seen a foot deep in that right hand line. And so I know that sometime in the future, somebody's going to go down through there and it's going to cause a bad creek. But I don't think they just look there. They're going to have to redo the drainage off that.
It definitely needs some help.
Yes.
We did take a vote on that resolution, didn't we? It carried. All right. But yeah, you're right, it's bad right there.
Yeah.
Next is, if you had an opportunity to review the budget transfers, this had to deal with the rubber modified asphalt project we've done and the Ditmore property. So if y'all have a question about that, if y'all remember, we closed on that property like either the 7th or the 11th of January, something like that. Of course, whoever owns the property on January 1 is responsible for taxes, but typically you prorate the taxes for for the period of time that the original owner had it versus the new owner. Of course, obviously, we were the new owner, and we got that tax bill, we had like almost 51 weeks of the year, so we didn't prorate. I mean, the tax liability on the owner would have been pennies for 1 week. But because the county did not own it on January 1, those taxes are still due. Now, it'll be exempt in the following years, but it had to be paid this year. And the code followed up and checked all that with the state and with the PBA office to make sure that was correct. So that's what that money's for there. Got a motion by Nate to approve the budget transfer. Second by Meyer. Any other questions or discussion? All in favor, aye. Any opposed? Motion carries. Next, gentlemen, if y'all have the opportunity to review the bills and claims, we would just need a motion and a second to approve those claims.
So moved.
Motion by Meyer. Second by Scott. Any question or discussion? Any opposed? Motion carries. And the next item, gentlemen, if you had an opportunity to review the September 30th, 2020 financial statement, we would need a motion and a second to approve this statement, subject to audit, and authorize the county treasurer and the county judge to sign it. Got a motion by Nate. Second by Marty. Any other question or discussion? All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? I believe we could have done this meeting, y'all.
We're about through here.
Getting into reports, I do have a few things. One thing that I want to do is that I have not done at this point, but I need you guys to acknowledge this, is I'm going to issue Executive Order 2020-10-20, and that executive order will be to appoint Pam Roberts as the Deputy Judge Executive. The purpose of that is in the event that I can't function or be in the office, although there may be days that those ladies say I can't function. That's what my wife says today, too. But she would have that responsibility in the event that I'm not able to be there. I don't think that requires a vote, but I do need y'all to acknowledge the receipt of the executive order. And I guess express your opinions if you have any thoughts negative for it.
I hope it doesn't happen, but I figure I should have better got it.
That's a very good possibility. There's one thing for sure, she's got more time in the office than I have. The next thing that I want to do is I want you to come in here with us for a minute. He didn't know I was going to do this, but I want to thank Bobby, you and all of your crew for two particular projects here. After the accident there at the intersection of Coomer and Swanson Road, we immediately got on working. What we could do to try to bring some attention to that four-way stop. Bobby took care of getting these rumble strips down. I'm sure, Myron, you've been out there and seen that. And would you agree that it's got to be
the helpful?
And I mean, you and your guys got on that and done it as quickly as the material come in to get the strips down, and I just want you to know we appreciate that work. And then your guys have been working on the courtyard. We've had literally, and Bill's out there, he can attest to this, the big hedges that was grown up over here, there was a hole back in there that had all Yeah, I think they said yesterday it was over 20% turnout already.
Right.
Yeah.
I talked to several that had never voted.
That finally voted.
Never voted, you know, it amazes me that somebody over 18 that's never voted. And it's just something I'm always, I'm just glad to see that everybody's gonna be out and exercise the right to vote.
And so what Manager Chandler's talking about too, the early voting is still taking place, will take place the rest of the week here at the courthouse, all next week at the courthouse, and then again on Monday, November 2nd here at the courthouse. And weekdays, it's 8 a.m. to 4 p.m., and on the Saturdays of those weeks, it'll be 8 to noon. And then on Election Day, you will have the ability to vote either here at the courthouse, over at Simpson Elementary on Witt Road, or out at the Ag Building at the Community Park.
Well, will those, Sheriff, will those hours on Election Day be like normal, 6 to 6, or?
I'd have to check, I think they will be though.
That's what I understand.
That's okay.
Yeah, I understand the normal polling hours.
Normal polling hours.
On Election Day.
So it'll be 6 to 6, like?
Yes.
Yes. That's all.
Thank you, Mark. Nathan?
Yeah, Board of Barricade, we have a meeting on last evening, and some of the things that went down, they are open up now for the kids to come back. They're on the same schedule as the Simpson County School System. They got blue and white days, and the maximum amount of kids each day is 50. Right now, they don't quite have that number. So you're getting the word out to all the parents and grandparents, you know, and you can sign your kids up, you know, and that once you get to 50, then they're going out to start screening the kids more about who come down there, you know. But right now, they're trying to get the word out more about, you know, bring your kids on down there. So it's a place to air out for the weekend, you know, be ready for them coming in on Monday. And also, we're getting ready to start looking for some more board members. We got a few seats to fill for next year, you know, and we got the criteria. We're trying to gather up people that not as across the board, you know, that can bring something to the table for this community and for the kids, you know, to have better ourselves overall. And that's all that happened. No more than just continue to come out and vote, you know, voice, you know, because your vote is your voice. You know, if you don't vote, you don't have a voice in that.
All right, thank you, Nate. Scott?
The thing I've got is, of course, the bridge on 621 Stevenson Road. Still out. It's like it won't be out for a while yet. So that, and I talked to one of the residents on Salmon's Blackjack Road, and he's got a hole right there on the road. But it's a state highway, so I'll call Barry and have him come look at that. And that's all I got.
All right, thank you. Myron?
I'd like to thank our public work department again. I talked to several of our residents out, and what they are telling me is working. I did talk to Joe Pope last week concerning a flashing light, a caution light. And we've not had no accidents on Squires Road, which is the state highway. But again, what our department is working, people are stopping. Of course, the corn's down in the end season. So again, I want to thank the department for that. Also, I'd like to thank Chad Drake and the jail. I know last Wednesday, you guys had audit, if you will, on how you can be more efficient for us operating jail for utilities and things of that nature. Now, I do appreciate you being proactive on it.
Bobby, you have anything? Bill, I skipped over the elected officials. They're going to sheriff's on the record. I did. I skipped over the counselor too. Counselor, you have anything?
And
Taxes and voting, but y'all have already hit on that, so no report.
All right, Jay, do you have anything?
Just, well,